I can't believe it. It's been a long, tough road, but we finally made it. The final unit of computer skills. In this course, you've learned what computers are made of, how they work, and so many different ways you can use them in your everyday life. There's only one thing to do: prove yourself a master of computer skills by using everything you've learned. By the end of this lesson, you'll understand what is required in the final research project, and you'll get to choose your research topic. Let's get into it. This final project will be broken up into three stages: conducting your research, making your product, and sharing your research. Each stage will require you to use what you've learned throughout this computer skills course. In the first stage, conducting your research, you'll use what you've learned about internet research to scour the web for information on your chosen topic. You'll have to carefully craft your searches to find valuable information. Evaluate the credibility and biases of the sources that you find to determine what information is trustworthy, and make sure that, as you're collecting information, you're also respecting others' intellectual property and not just stealing other people's ideas and work. Once you think you've gathered enough information, it's time to make your product. This is when you'll get to use those skills you learned from the productivity software unit. It's up to you whether you write a research paper or design a presentation, and bonus points if you include some graphs or charts you made using spreadsheet software. Remember, while some productivity software is only available to paying customers, you can get full access to Google Docs, Google Slides, and Google Sheets just by having a free Google account. Finally, once you've used the information you found in your research to create your masterpiece, don't just keep it to yourself. Share it. Present your product to friends, family, and teachers using email, video conferencing, or any of the other methods you learned about throughout the course so they can witness how much you're learning and growing. If you'd like, you can even share your research with other Mi Academy students through our video or newspaper features. Because this final project is focused on using things you've already learned and learning new information of your own choosing, the lessons will look a little different than usual. Each lesson will contain only two components: a project PDF and a practice. First, review the list of related skills in the PDF, then test yourself on those skills using the practice. Make sure to review past lessons as needed. Once you've mastered the practice, you're ready to return to the project PDF and work on that stage of the project. Continue to do this for each lesson in the unit, and you'll finish this final project with a complete understanding of all the skills you've gained throughout the course. But there's so much information on the web. How will you even decide what to research? Well, this is a course all about how computers can be used throughout your everyday life. So, why not research how computers relate to your favorite activities? Who knows? Maybe you'll learn something that makes your favorite hobbies even more enjoyable through the use of computers. Even non-digital hobbies can benefit from computers, like sports. You could research the way some sports use AI referees to instantly make decisions that might be more difficult for human referees. Or you could focus on how video software is used to create instant replays and provide performance analysis to help players improve. And not all sports training takes place in the real world. You could research how athletes use sports simulations and video games to improve their performance on and off the field. Honestly, video games could be a whole research topic of their own. How did the widespread adoption of the internet change gaming? How does VR gaming translate our physical movements into in-game actions? How did games evolve from giant arcade machines to tiny games we can fit in our pockets? Oh, speaking of, What about researching how society changed when smartphones were invented? You could learn how both one-on-one and group communications changed, how smartphones resulted in tough conversations about personal privacy, or how news and education evolved due to smartphones. If you enjoy using computers for video streaming, you could research streaming services. You could discover how the movie industry as a whole had to adapt when streaming became popular, how streaming services changed the way we view licensing and copyrights, or how they made international content more accessible to a global population. And video isn't the only art form that has benefited from computers. If you're an artist of any form, research how computers can be used to enhance your craft. Visual artists can use digital drawing and painting. If you're a fashion designer, there are 3D design programs for you. Photographers can digitally alter their photos. Musicians have digital instruments and audio mixers. Whatever your art form, there's probably an app for that. And what about the art form of the web itself? Web design. What are the fundamental rules for designing interfaces to create the best experience possible for users? How do web designers make their websites more universally accessible for all users, including users with disabilities? How do social media sites encourage interaction within digital communities? Oh my goodness, my mind is racing with a bazillion different ideas. You know what? I'm going to write down all of my ideas and leave them in the lesson PDF for you to choose from. And there are probably a bazillion more ideas that I didn't think of. If you have a topic in mind that isn't listed in the PDF, ask your instructor if they think it's a good fit for this project. Oh, that's another great idea. Oh, and what, you know, I have always wondered. Good luck on this project. I look forward to seeing what amazing information you dig up online about your favorite hobbies. As always, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. Hey, hey.